This is the end of the beginning. Welcome to today's show. I wanted to cover this theory out there that's going around about the direct energy weapon in Maui, which pretty much has been proven. All one has to do is use their own eyes and see how these homes were specifically targeted. And one of the stories out there is about the color blue, how blue houses and blue things like blue cars didn't happen to catch fire and melt. Now, I'm going to cover this story, and I'm going to talk about direct energy weapons. I'm going to show you how these lasers can target. I'm also going to talk about some of the other things that I've shown you, which prove that this is a direct energy weapon. Okay, and how they've scrubbed an article from the internet, which was out there that they've scrubbed, and they're trying to pretend like, oh, this article never actually existed, but there's truth behind it. Now, there's also some things that might be exaggerated, so we're going to look at all those things in a second. I want to let everybody know over on my website, uprisingrevival.com. If you haven't heard, I have a website. It's $2.99 a month. It's troll-free. There's a lot of great content over there. I hope people will join and share information. Share what you're seeing. Even if you look at other channels, BitChute channels, whatever channels, other YouTubers, TikTok, share that stuff over there. You have the ability to do that. You can also tell your own story, things that are going on in your life, things you're seeing in your town, in the forum section, so that people can become awake and aware and see what's going on. It's uprisingrevival.com, and I have a new video up over there. And I'm going to have a lot of new videos up over there about the outbreak that's coming again and the mandates that are coming. But about the event in California, about a shop that had a flag outside the shop and an event occurred, it's a very important video. It's very important that people understand how these psyops work and what the point is. It is obviously, if you look into the characteristics of the person who they claim is responsible for the event, you'll always see the same signs, right? You'll see that they're Christian. They're devout Christians. They're devout followers of Christ. They did this for God, et cetera, et cetera. This is all to strip rights from Christians to label things as hate speech and, again, to remove the Bible. So that video is available exclusively on the website, uprisingrevival.com. Check it out now if you can. I highly recommend it. Now, to this story, if you didn't see some of the video footage that's out there, some houses with blue roofs survived. Cars that were blue didn't get melted like other cars got melted. You can actually still see that they're blue. Blue umbrellas stood standing right next to a hole that was completely wiped out. So there's suspicion about the lasers targeting colors using frequency and wavelength, which I've talked about. And this is one of the videos that people are using and showing out there of a laser where the laser is destroying tarps that are specific colors, but it's leaving the blue out. And this has to do with the actual beam and the lens of the beam and the color of the lens of the beam. But take a look at this video that is viral at the moment. So, what you're seeing there is how laser technology, how this technology can specifically target spots, right? And there is 100% truth to this, whether you believe that this was the case in Maui or not. What everyone should believe is that it was a direct energy weapon. Now, there are obviously places left standing that did not have blue roofs. One of the things that they can do is they can lock on to smart meters and target specific homes and do this to specific homes if they want to. And they can leave specific homes if they choose to leave specific homes. That's why we saw the balloon flying above the satellite with the green lasers. They were topographic. They were reading everything on the ground level. We see this happening all the time now. They're finding areas. They're reading what's there. They know what they want to destroy and what they don't. There are specific places they do not want destroyed, obviously. They don't want celebrities' homes destroyed, right? Very conveniently. Why would they? They're their, they're their social influencers. These celebrities are one with them. They need the celebrities because the celebrities are the ones that control the minds of the masses, not the politicians, the little bit of the politicians these days, but not so much as the celebrities as Oprah and all these famous Taylor Swift, et cetera, et cetera. Their job is to socially engineer the masses. So these people are never going to be sacrificed until they don't need them anymore. Then they can discard them if they choose. So one of the things was this article that was out there, and they're trying to debunk this article. You can decide for yourself if it's real, but you can't find the article anymore. of course you can't find the article anymore, because this is something that they do. They do scrape articles off of the internet, just like they scrape YouTube channels, right? A lot of people out there can't find a certain YouTuber anymore because he doesn't use the same name he used to use. Ever remember that guy? Why? Because they scrub them off the internet. Well, they do this all the time. So for anyone out there that's like, well, I tried to find the article and I couldn't find the article. Well, once this event happened, the first thing people said was a direct energy weapon. Why? Well, they saw what happened in California a few years ago, and they saw how trees were still standing in Maui, and how a couple homes were still standing up, and a church was standing up in Lahaina, but everything else looked like it was melted. It looked like it was out of a war zone. Homes didn't just burn, they burnt to the ground. Cars were melted. Okay, we're not talking about homes that catch fire and you put the fire out, but there's still a structure of the home. Nothing was left standing, as we all saw. So this article was titled, "Why the heck are celebs all painting their Maui properties the same weird shade of blue? Obama, Clinton, Hanks, DeGeneres, Tegan, Kid Rock, and now Oprah. What exactly do billionaires see in this frankly off-putting color?" Okay, so yes, there's truth behind it. Now, there's truth behind the fact that DEW weapons target specific areas. Can they target based on colors and roof colors? Yeah, they can. But what if you look at the flip side of this, and I'm not making an argument that it's not targeting blue. I'm just specifically saying there's only a few photographs of things that were blue that were left standing. Okay, there'll probably be a lot more blue cars out there for people to see than just one or two blue car photos that show up. So, yes, it makes me skeptical that it was blue, that they targeted via the color blue. I'm not saying it is or it isn't. I'm just showing you what's out there and what people are talking about. However, direct energy weapons can specifically target based on color. They can specifically target based on the topographic that they use to pick actual targets that you want to eliminate. And that's not something that's out of the realm of possibility. It's 100% fact. If you look at direct energy weapons and the military's use of them, what do you think? They're just spraying lasers into the sky, hoping it hits a missile or hoping it hits a quote-unquote enemy target? Of course it's a direct hit. It's a direct geolocation, topograph. They know everything about what they're targeting and hitting, and they're hitting it in a nanosecond, quickly. Okay, so they obviously map this out. They obviously use the DEW, and all one has to do is use their own eyes. You don't have to sit here and be like, look, there's homes with blue roofs. You shouldn't have to, because you see things that are still standing. You see the degree or the level of things being demolished there. You see cars melting. You see our own government completely ignoring what happened in Maui, finally sending Biden out 12 days later where he's sleeping and he's telling stories. Did anyone see this? Telling stories about how he had a home that burned and trying to relate this to himself? I mean, I can't believe people actually sat out there and listened to this garbage.
Just surveyed the damage. I want you to know, whatever it takes, as long as I look at your congressmen and senators and governor and lieutenant governor, we're going to get it done for you. But get it done the way you want it done, not get it done somebody else's way. If I mean it, I don't want to compare difficulties, but we have a little sense, Jill and I, what it's like to lose a home. Years ago, now 15 years ago, I was in Washington doing Meet the Press. It was a sunny Sunday. Lightning struck at home on a little lake. It's outside of our home, not a lake, a big pond. And hit a wire and came up underneath our home into the heating ducts, the air conditioning duct. Make a long story short, almost lost my wife, my 67 Corvette, and my cat. But all kidding aside, I watched the firefighters, the way they responded. You know, there's an old expression. I grew up right across the street from a fire hall in Claymont, Delaware. And the expression is, God made man, then he made a few firefighters. You're all crazy, thank God. The only people who run into flames to help other people. And they ran into flames, saved my wife, saved my family. Not a joke. The smoke and the firefighters, I can tell you, sometimes smoke is so thick, from the windows out, it was that thick inside the home. And we were insured. We did not have any problem. But being out of our home for a better part of a year was difficult. I can only imagine what it's like to lose your home completely. completely burned to the ground. And more importantly, all the things that matter to you from that ring he gave you when you were 19 years old, from that special letter that came for your son or your daughter, the little things that matter most, the album, the family albums, all of it is a touchstone to all the things we care about and lose.
So, obviously, I mean, there's so many signs that show the government's in on it. You can look at the land grab they tried to do in Maui years ago. You can look at all the land they own in Hawaii, all the celebrities that own land in the Hawaiian Islands. Clearly, this is a hideout and an escape for them when they continue to do what they're doing here in America, which is start burning everything to the ground using direct energy weapons, using people's smart meters, all these types of things. If you didn't see my video on the smart meters, go check it out. Okay, they have the ability to do this stuff, and this is exactly what they've been waiting for and wanting, is to have this in place and keep people distracted, because nobody's going to point a finger at them. The illusion has always been that the government is going to roll down the street, bring in martial law with tanks, and go after the civilians just out of the blue. They're going after civilians, but they're rounding civilians up in the name of climate change. All of our rights are going to be stripped in the name of climate change, all things that they're doing and creating. But nobody's paying attention to it. They're too distracted with nonsense. You don't hear any of the alt-right talking about this stuff. If they bring it up, they're like, oh, did you hear the conspiracy about a direct energy weapon? Conspiracy? This could, I mean, if all one has to do is look at the evidence that is there, use your own eyes. What are you going to, oh, the scientists are going to tell you, oh, the electrical cable on the ground. Oh, you just see the ground starting to light up. That's a direct energy weapon. Okay? Pointed right at that spot. They're just starting to melt things. And for, I mean, it's insane that people actually believe the narrative that they give. It is so, not only is it far-fetched, it, even the stories they give do not coincide with the evidence that's out there with your own eyes that you can see. Right? You look at this, it looks worse than Ukraine, the pictures in Ukraine, which we know what's going on there, but I can't get into it on YouTube. But it looks like something that could not actually happen without it being created by these people. So the one article that's out there is pointing at the fact that these celebrities have all painted their houses blue so that the direct energy weapon would know to avoid the home. So the technology does exist. Is the story true? Could be true. I mean, we haven't heard a single story about a celebrity's home burning down. So there's truth to that from the standpoint that the direct energy weapon clearly was avoiding celebrities' homes because they're all working together. Why do you think all the celebrities have the same politics, right? There's like three celebrities who happen to be conservative, right? John Voight, James Woods, who is very skeptical. You might look at some of James Woods' posts and be like, oh, he's great. You know, he's very anti-Biden and all this garbage that the communists are doing. Oh, well, James Woods was in the movie about McMartin, and he was interviewed at the time, and he said the whole thing wasn't real. So you tell me. Did he change his mind? Maybe he did. Did he ever go back and say, hey, you know, I was wrong. I shouldn't even have played in the movie because they found the tunnels underneath the school. No, you don't hear that stuff, right? So the celebrity, there's a few celebrities who are conservative. Every one of them is communist, which goes back to the Hollywood blacklist. When Hollywood was infiltrated by communists and they were cast out, well, now they completely control Hollywood, which is why they all have the same politics, right? So all of these people with the same politics all serve a purpose because they're the influencers of society. They're the reason that all of these dumbed-down kids and Gen Zers and millennials exist is because of Hollywood. They worship and they're idolaters of these people. So these people are not going to be touched in these situations because they need these people. These people are working with the government. So why would they burn their homes down? So conveniently, none of their homes get burnt down. You could say, well, they don't live in Lahaina. Well, there are three fires that started out there, some of which were pretty close to Oprah's home in proximity. Of course, Oprah wasn't going to be touched. Come on. And they're pretty upset that most people started calling these celebrities out. I mean, I called them out. As soon as this event happened, I saw a lot of people were calling them out. So that's good. I mean, call them out. Wake people up. But unfortunately, there's a large portion of people who defend these celebrities because they're idolaters. They love the ground. They love them, and they worship the ground they walk on. They will kiss their rear end. They will wipe their rear end for them if they ask. They're sick. They're demented. So the direct energy weapon clearly ignored these people. Was it based on color coordination? It's possible, but I think we would see more blue things. But the umbrellas are very suspicious. Obviously, seeing a blue car that's not melted is suspicious. And then there were some blue bins and other blue things that were sitting around, you know, downtown Lahaina next to trees. So the trees didn't get melted, and those didn't get melted. That should be enough for people. Garbage cans that were blue didn't get melted. So do I believe that it was actually based on color? I believe it's very well could be possible. But there's also other homes that aren't blue that were left standing. So to me, that tells me that the direct energy weapon was based on geolocation, right? That they targeted it on smart meters. They left certain ones out. They picked this place, picked that place, left the church out for whatever reason, probably because they used the church. You know, I know a lot of people out there were like, the church didn't burn because of God, maybe so. At the same time, if you studied how these secret societies work, a lot of them go through Catholicism and other churches that use them, that, you know, use the basements of these churches, like these Freemason lodges. I don't know. I'm not saying one way or the other, but obviously the places that were left standing for a reason. Otherwise, they would have fried every single place over in that area. Okay? Maybe they left a few because they didn't want it to look suspicious, but it looks suspicious, right? Why? Well, because so many trees didn't burn. And so many idiots out there, no matter what, and this is how communist works, will defend the government till their death. Till their death. The government comes out and says masks need to be back without even giving you reason for it, they'll put them on. They'll tell you that you need to wear it. They don't even need explanation as to why a certain magic potion doesn't make them immune. They don't need an explanation on it. Why? Because they're soldiers for the communist regime. They're suckers. They're as dumb as they come. They're walking zombies. They've all gotten lobotomies. And when you see an event like Maui, if you don't connect the dots just based on the evidence that you see with your own eyes, then you're not thinking. You're pretty much operating, like I always say, on autopilot. So they want these stories out there in a sense so they can either, one, debunk them. And I also thought it was pretty amazing that the article that supposedly was scrubbed, which it looks like it was scrubbed, has a Twitter explanation. I love how people are like, oh, Twitter is so pro-God. Elon Musk is pro-God. And has an explanation that they're debunking the article already. This is a relatively new story about the blue homes just a few days ago. Not like, even 2 weeks ago. They're already ready to debunk the stuff, which tells you that something was already in place, which means they get their orders from the CIA and the FBI, so they already told them, hey, anything that has this tag in it, right, that says anything about blue homes, et cetera, put this underneath the post. Put this underneath, like on YouTube, put it under the video. The algorithm hears me say a certain sentence or word, put it under the video about the climate, about secret societies, about NATO, all of it. They'll read stuff and they'll put stuff underneath it, whether they hear it in the video or they read it in a post. And that's because the government has put these things in place. So anything you see that has a fact check underneath it, believe the opposite. Because it's the government who's already got an excuse in place because they know that the herded sheep, or I shouldn't say sheep because it gets people upset, the herded zombies will follow whatever they say and just go right to the fact check and believe it because they're so stupid. So anytime you see a fact check, disregard it and realize what they're doing. But I showed you the video clip. You obviously know direct energy weapons are targeted weapons. They're not something that's just going to fry Maui just without picking places it wants to fry. Yeah. But it has the capability to leave certain places out. Now, was it based on blue or not? You tell me. But clearly, there were places left standing for a reason. And those trees that are still up, yeah, that should be enough evidence for anybody else. And if that wasn't enough evidence, the video I did the other day on Maui brain fire, if you haven't watched it, go back through my videos and watch it. Okay? They're literally coming up with a disease based off of wildfires, which tells you it's Havana syndrome, which is side effects from having a direct energy weapon on you, hitting you, okay? The same side effects are now apparently coming from wildfires and trauma from climate change, okay? So the fact that that story's out there, and they're telling you that people are suffering from brain fire, brain memory loss because of the fires, tells you it was a direct energy weapon, 100%. So go watch that video if you haven't. The proof is in the pudding, as they say, but the proof is really all over the place. I thank everyone for being here. I hope you're all doing well. Hope to see you on the website, uprisingrevival.com. And again, thanks again for being here. God bless all of you and your families. Okay.
people.